Hello there, and welcome to another Starfield ship review. In today's review, we're going to be looking at the Ecliptic Bayonet. There is multiple tiers of this ship, like most NPC ships, but I only have the tier 1 version of it. So if you have a tier 2 or a tier 3, the stats will be slightly better, but ship aesthetically will be the same. So yeah, as the name suggests, this belongs to the mercenary faction called Ecliptic. They're generally the bad guys in the game. I think you can come across a couple of friendly groups, but for the most part they spend the game harassing you and attacking you. So this looks like it's hard to tell, because it looks like it's based off a Tyo vessel, but I see some Hope Tech pieces too. Now, I have yet to review a ship to my knowledge that looks like this, so I don't know if it is a custom ship or if it is based on something else. Someone in the comments might be able to let me know if you recognize as a different ship. Usually with the NPC factions, the enemy factions, they tend to just kind of take a ship that's owned by, like, let's say, Nova Galactic, and they just kind of give it a different color scheme and some better weapons. But yeah, anyway, let's get into the stats. So it's got a fuel of 100, which is absolutely abysmal. You're not going to be able to jump anywhere on this ship with that amount of fuel. I would recommend upgrading it almost immediately so you can make some decent jumps. It's got a hull of 474, which is pretty low. I wouldn't be fighting in this ship. I don't know what the Ecliptics were doing with a ship that low. And then we've got a cargo capacity of 410, which isn't bad. Like, these Ecliptic vessels are primarily combat vessels, so like having a little bit of extra storage is kind of handy. Got an A-class reactor, 18 power, which is extremely low power. Like, that's not good. Crew of 3, which isn't bad. Jump range of 15 light years, very bad. Just, yeah. You'll be able to cover most of the settle system, but if you start to explore, you're going to find run into trouble with that fuel and that jump drive. It's got a shield of 390, which, again, is quite bad. I'd probably recommend, if you like this style of ship, I definitely upgrade the reactor, the jump drive, and the shield. And then for weaponry, it's got a single particle cannon there on the port side. It's got a pair of EM weapons there on the starboard side. And then it's got a missile launcher on the port side as well. Now, obviously, I'm going to buy this ship, but you can't buy this ship. In order to get this ship or any of the other Ecliptic vessels, you have to come across them. Now, two main ways is you go to a system that's far away from the settled area. And then if you jump between planets, you have random events can spawn, and you might get an event where basically the Ecliptics attack you. Now, the other method is to land on a planet, and then when you land on a planet and exit your ship for the first time, again, a random event can happen where a ship will land. You can kind of save scum. If you basically reload the autosave of you leaving your ship, it'll generate a new random event. I did that to get this ship. It took me probably 20 minutes to get this ship to spawn, and then I just chase it down and board it. Yeah. Anyway, let's go take a look at it. I'm not really expecting much from this, because it is quite a... It looks very cool. Like, they use their the Hope Tech landing gear, which they I really like the look of. I believe they're Hope Tech. And then we have the... I'm going to get a little glamour shot. Oh, no. And then we have the... The Deimos, you can see it there, the Deimos winglets, which are really, really nice. Got a lot going on at the top there. I don't know why they felt the need to use Hope Tech pieces, but you know, you do what you gotta do. So let's go check it out as I sprain my ankle. So entry is through the front in a Tyo entryway. Pretty nice. It's got a door, which is always nice. And then immediately we have a 1x1 storage room from Tyo. If we jump up here, they put an engine room on the ship? Are you serious?
I'm listening.
Okay, apparently they decided to put a 3x1 engine room from Tyo on the ship. Which wouldn't be my setup for a ship, like A-class ship. These sort of like engine rooms are kind of like aesthetic pieces, like modules you add when you know like your ship is kind of big and you're running out, like, what do I put here? Usually you slap one of these down. I would recommend definitely removing this. Well, in the teardown I'll show you what I would put instead. Yeah, it's like, don't get me wrong, it's cool, like, from a like a lore and roleplay point of view, but if you're trying to be practical, this adds nothing at all. Which they kind of should. I feel like all the habitats should add something. And then if we go up one floor here, we have another Hope Tech storage room that leads to the docking port. So back down we go. And if we head this way, really? If that really need to be there, like, could you not just put the wires away? No, you gotta just leave them there and then put a little, like, oh, don't stand there. Anyway, we've got the, hello, Cora. We have the Tayo Bridge, which the Tayo Bridges always look really cool. They're very, like, luxurious and sleek. Only real problem with it is you've got these, like, crew seats here, and they look like they're cool, but it seems more like a kind of, like, you're flying, like, you know, like a private jet or like a limousine. Like, you're trying to give your passengers, like, a good view. Anyway, let's ignore them having a family spackle in the background. Let's see how she performs. I'm assuming we're going to have a lot of issues with the engine power of this vessel. Interesting placement of the engines, having them, like, up higher. Let's take her off. Okay, so current configuration, it looks like we won't need too much power. Those big engines. But yeah, as always, I have a perk that increases my power by 5 pips, so for the sake of this, we're going to be removing 5 pips. So weapon-wise, we got the particle weapon there on the port side. We've got 2 EM weapons on the starboard side, and then we've got the missile launcher on the top. It's not a bad configuration. The particle and the missiles work well together because they can both damage shields and hull. And then the EMs are nice, you know, if you need to board ships. So speed-wise, it's got a base speed of 150, which is pretty average. Like, 150 is usually, like, the kind of the best you can get, unless you opt for the engines that allow you to go 180. It has a boost speed of, okay, yeah, it's fast. Boost-wise, pretty fast. Almost 600 boost speed, which is really good. We'll do a quick agility test. Pitch. Which is quite good. It's like a, probably like a 7 maybe. The yaw, ooh, that feels slower, but I think it's actually faster. Yeah, it's probably about 7 or an 8 too. And then the roll. Well, the roll's always the roll, you never really know. A little interesting tidbit before we go down to the teardown. So you notice when I'm accelerating with the engines, you have obviously the massive engines there accelerating with me. But at the bottom there, what look like engines, they're not actually engines. Well, they are, but they're actually landing gear. So for some reason, Bethesda decided to make the landing gear actually work as engines, but they don't give you any engine stats, so they're purely aesthetic. Just an interesting tidbit. Anyway, we're going to head down to the planet now and do a teardown. Okay, so here we are in the shipbuilder. So we split into 3 sections. On the top section, we have the Hope Tech companionway 1x1 with a extender port 200 docker from Tayo above it. And then behind that, we have the Tokamak X100 reactor from Jiang. It's an A-class with 18 power. That power is quite abysmal. So let's see what we have working here. I'm at a different location here, so it's probably not going to show me much. We have... Obviously, you can get higher tier reactors. This is the higher tier one I have, a Parima. But I know you can get up to like 29 and potentially like 33. So I would definitely recommend upgrading that reactor as soon as possible. As for the shield, we have a Bastille S81 shield generator from Nautilus. A-class, 4 power, 390 shield health. Now, there's far better shields. So you have this one, Dogstar, which is 810. Which would kind of fit the aesthetic a little bit. This is 16,090. This is 4,000. So you're paying like 4 times as much, but you're getting over almost triple. Not triple, about double. Weaponry, we have mounted on a Horizon weapon mount. We have the EMP suppressor. It's an A-class from Ballistic Solutions. It's 960 range, 1.5 fire rate. 36 damage to hull, 24 electromagnetic damage, and requires 4 power. On the opposite side, also mounted on a Horizon weapon mount, we have an Atlatl 270A missile launcher from Lightsight, A-class, 4800 range, 1 fire rate, 49.34 damage to hull and shields, and 3 max power. Behind them we have these two 100G Helium 3 tanks that give 50 jump fuel, which is pretty bad. I would recommend upgrading. Let me see what we have. So currently we're using these ones. We could probably opt for these. So these are 1800 to buy and they have a mass of 16 versus 1000 to buy and 10. So these, you could replace these with some of these to get up to 200, which is a decent starting point. And they don't change the aesthetic of the ship too much. They kind of add a little bit more to it, a bit more character. But anyway, we'll put them back. And then we have this these Ares DT-40 engines from Panoptes, A-class, 2 power, 10,800 engine thrust, 2,200 maneuvering thrust. And then we have this Nova Bracer from Nova Galactic. And finally, we have this Hope Tech Nose B on the front. So that's it for this section. And then we go to the middle. So we have the Samurai cockpit from Taiyo Astroneering, 200 cargo, 2 crew station. Behind that, we have the Taiyo Engineering Bay 3x1 Top B. It gives 1 crew station, but I would recommend swapping this out. Let me see here. So I don't have any Taiyo here currently, but we'll use Nova Galactic as a stand-in. I'd probably slap down a control station to get a bit of extra crew, and then put like a 1x1 behind it. As for the grav drive, we've got the NG-160 grav drive from Nova Galactic, A-class. It's got a power of 8, and it's got a grav jump thrust of 13. Now, the thing is, this is like scraping the barrel in grav drives. You can get far better grav drives without really extending your budget very much. So, for instance, this one here, this Helios 400 grav drive, or we'll do this one for now. So if this one costs 7,600 versus the 4,000, this gives us a jump range of 27 light years. So it's like almost double jump range. That just goes to show, like, Nova Galactic, they make nice ships, but their grav drives are pretty poopy. And then for weaponry, we've got this EMP-80 suppressor, same as the one before, mounted on the winglet. And then we've got this Disruptor 3300A auto-electron beam from Horizon Defense, A-class, 4,200 range, 6.6 fire rate, 8 damage to shield and hull, and 3 power. Interestingly, I don't know why they didn't mount that there with the other one. It seems kind of weird. Oh, it probably might have clipped, but anyway. And then for the aesthetics, we have a pair of these Deimos Wings A, port and starboard. Really love these wings. And then we've got a pair of these Deimos Wings C, starboard and port. Again, really love these wings. They look really cool. They look kind of like radiators, like, you know, they're trying to disperse the heat. And then on the bottom, we have this shipbed 200 landing bay from Taiyo Astroneering. Behind that, we have a Deimos 1x1 companionway. And then behind that, we have a Deimos hull. Interesting. And then we have the 100cm ballast cargo hold for a little bit of extra cargo hold. Gives us 210. Oh, these are Taiyo. Interesting. I thought these were Hope Tech. Okay. So we've got the Pinpoint 3G landing gear port 4 and starboard 4. And then we've got the Pinpoint 3G landing gear starboard mid and port mid. And then we have the aft port and the starboard port aft and starboard aft. Okay. I read that wrong. So these are the ones that give you actual engines, which is kind of interesting. But as you see, they don't give you any actual thrust aside from landing gear thrust. But yeah, that was the ship. Let me know what you guys think of it. Have you guys flown it, or would you like to fly it? Does it look like the sort of ship you'd like to fly? I feel like it's definitely a work in progress. Like, because I found the lower tier one, you're better off finding the higher tier one and seeing that. I don't think the stats are going to improve that much, though. This is definitely like a kind of a fixer-upper if I've ever seen one. But anyway, as always, thanks for watching, guys. If you like this sort of content, don't forget to subscribe and also check out my other reviews. Bye.